We're going to take a talk with an expert on how you can maximize your productivity.
By now, you've likely dedicated a space to working from home, but are you finding it difficult to really tackle everything? Organizing expert Mindy Arnold, owner of Richmond-based home organizing and senior downsizing firm Abundance Organizing, joins us by Skype with steps to boost productivity while working from home. Mindy, it's wonderful to see you.
It's great to see you, Jessica. Thanks for having me.
It's our pleasure. We had a little sneak peek of some of the work that you're doing with virtual sessions, helping folks right now, really struggling because I think we're home so much more and seeing all of these problem areas we haven't tackled before. But this is a whole new thing, working from home, and it's not familiar for those who were not in this arena before.
No, and it's interesting. We've actually been seeing a trend in organizing recently where people have been either minimizing their home offices completely or making them multifunction space. So right now, I'm talking to you from my former home office that is now my yoga and meditation room.
So I saw this because I follow you on Instagram, right? And I saw that this conversion happened, and I did find it confounding because I thought, well, wait, don't we need the home office? So was that was already a trend beforehand, was maybe minimizing that space into something else?
Yes. And for me, my home office was really sitting idle most of the time. I've been running my business from my home office for 10 years now, but there are other places in my house that I'm much more comfortable working. Mm. So I tend to move around and change it up depending on the light that's coming in a certain window or wherever I want to be in that day, in that moment.
Isn't that interesting? Well, you have three areas for us to focus on. We start with space. That's tip number one, and that seems like what you were doing, capitalizing on the best space.
Right. So any of the three, space, time, and state of mind, if it's not fully functional, then you're really not going to be as productive as you could be from your home work environment. So the first tip I always focus on is to eliminate distraction wherever you can. If you're lucky enough to have a home office where you can shut the door and shut everything else out, great. But even in our home office environments, we've noticed that there are piles of paper. There are a lot of visual distractions that are taking our attention away from our work. So in virtual organizing sessions recently with our clients who've been setting up home spaces and home office work, we've been telling them we never do this, but for a short-term fix, just sweep all the visual distractions, all those piles of papers into a box, put it outside of your line of sight so that you can really focus on the task at hand. So that's first, just getting rid of visual distractions.
We did that the other day. And, I find myself trying to be adept with organizing most of the time, but just getting it out of there did help tremendously. And it kind of segues into your next tip, making yourself comfortable, really finding that comfortable setup.
Yeah, so the thing about the home office environment is we often haven't spent enough time thinking about making our body comfortable for long stretches of work. If you can find a firm yet comfortable chair, I recommend that my clients try standing every once in a while just to change their posture and to see what's going to make their body comfortable, because you don't want your body to fatigue. So change that location and setting up. Try different spaces in your home, try different types of chairs, and really just see what you can do to keep your body feeling healthy and functional so that your brain gets as much energy as it needs for you to focus.
We have about 2.5 minutes left. I know the other tips there in the space category, enhance the vibe and then separation between home and work life. Those are both key.
Yes, getting good quality light, which is something that really often gets overlooked, either natural light or with a good task lighting. Having scents like a candle or diffusing oils, which is my favorite thing to do. Playing soft music. This is a great tool. Having a set of noise-canceling headphones that eliminates noise distraction, but also gives you nice soothing music. So anything to give you a good vibe.
Let's shift gears to time. This is one of those other areas that's a little bit of a sticky wicket for folks, time management.
Yes. So most important is starting with setting your goals for the day. I recommend if you've got coworkers, right, your children, your partner, anyone else that's sharing your space, everyone comes together at the beginning of the day and talks about what are the goals that I need to accomplish and what are we going to do to get there. Everyone supports each other in meeting their goals. As much as you can set a routine during this time, I recommend starting and stopping your workday at the same time every day and working in blocks of time. So using a timer, turning off all the notifications that are buzzing on your phone or your computer, and really focusing just on work for short, brief blasts can boost your productivity.
Making sure that you take a little bit of a break too can kind of recharge you and then maybe squeeze a little extra out.
Yeah, exactly. Taking your lunch break, just like you would if you were at the office. You know, we lose a lot of the cues that we have with the social environment of the office. So anything that you can do to take breaks to give your body and your mind a recharge is going to help you be more focused when you come back to your work.
And quickly, let's talk through tip number three, which is state of mind.
Yes. So finding ways to connect with the people that make you happy and make you feel supported. So using tools like Skype, like we're doing today, or Zoom, or other types of meetings where you can connect virtually with people who are going to make you happy. I recommend doing everything you can in your work environment to stay hydrated. So for me, it's not just having a glass of water, but I make sure that I have a whole pitcher of water at my desk, so that I don't have to get up and stop working to give myself water when I need to hydrate. Same thing in the opposite direction, keep the snacks far away. Keep those cookies in the kitchen. Don't have the plate sitting on your desk surface.
Yeah, definitely a good idea. You had suggested reaching out to a body double, building in time for movement, building in time for stillness, and taking a breath of fresh air.
Fresh air. Yes. A body double is just someone who is in your environment, but they're not engaging you. Something about having somebody just there helps you focus, helps you ground. And I find that people are much more productive. This is a technique that organizers have been using for years with our clients.
Really interesting. So even if you do that virtually now, it may help ground you. You guys are working together, but separately.
That's right. Having that accountability partner and just having someone else in your environment who is being productive and being focused helps you do the same.
Very good insight. And also, Mindy, talk us through really briefly. You've created a Facebook group for folks, haven't you?
We have. This is a way of our business pivoting, just like many here locally. We're trying to offer support and engagement to our community and share our expertise in a way that's easy to access. So the group is called Home Organizing Support During COVID-19. All of our 10 organizing consultants are there. They're showing their own projects at home. They're answering your questions. And a lot of people are sending in photos of their projects to get advice on how to move forward.
That's great. Thank you so much for being with us. We appreciate it.
Thank you so much for having me, Jessica.
Yep. Mindy Arnold of Abundance Organizing. We appreciate her making time and sharing these fantastic tips. We need all the help we can get. A reminder to find that Facebook group Abundance Organizing created. Search Home Organizing Support During COVID-19. And a direct link to all the company's information will be available later today, WTBR.com/VTM. Stay tuned. We'll be right back with more.